So when you do lookups, sooner or later, you will probably end up with a situation when you're trying to use a VLOOKUP or an XLOOKUP or index and match or whatever other lookup functions you like to use. And you may end up in the situation that instead of just one key that you need to match, you have multiple conditions. So to show you an actual example, we have this table with from and to destination for some freight. And if we go to the shipping cost table, you'll see it gives us what it costs for different from and to destinations. So just to see one example here, if we look at this one, it's going from New York to Vegas. So if I go here and search for New York, there it is. We should be able to match these two conditions and then bring over some information based on that. So that's what we're going to solve in this video. Now I'm going to show you how to solve this problem, whether you're in Excel or Google Sheets, in both cases. So I'll start by using Power Query to solve this problem. And that would be the easiest way to solve this problem. That being said, Power Query is only available if you are on a Windows version of Excel. So for those of you who are on Google Sheets or you're on a Mac version of Excel, you don't have that available to you. So to solve this lookup problem with multiple conditions, we're gonna use some other trickery, and I'll show you a function that will work for those cases too. So to solve this multiple criteria lookup problem using Power Query, we need to simply just convert these to actual tables in Excel. So I would go to this first one and quickly convert this to a table. I'm gonna go insert on top here, click table, and it has headers, so okay, good enough. I'm gonna go on top here and rename this table from table one. I will just call it shipments. You can call it anything you like. Then I'm gonna go to the shipping cost table right here, do the same thing, insert, make a table out of this, press okay. And I'm gonna name this table on top left. This will be shipping cost. So that's all I need to get started here. So now we're gonna connect both of these tables to our Power Query tool. And all we have to do for that, just go to data and click on one of these tables, click on this from table range option. And when that does the connection, it's going to load this. So we're simply going to go close on load two and close on load two. And we're simply going to create a connection to that table. So I'm gonna press okay. And I'm gonna repeat the same exact steps for my first table. So I'll click on this, go to from table range right here. And then again, close on load two. And only create connection, same thing. So now I got these two connections to both of those two tables. So I'm gonna grab the first table. This is the table where I want my results. So I'm gonna find it here, that connection. I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna do merge. And here, when we do merge, we're gonna show which table we're merging this to. And that's gonna be the shipping cost table. And usually, if you only had one key column, you would just say this and whatever that key column is, like this. But now we have two key columns. So what do you do in those cases? You first click on the first one, and then you press Control, and you click on the second one. Now, if you have a third one, you could have clicked then third one too to do like three conditions. I don't have that, so I'm gonna uncheck that one. So first one, second one. And then I'll go to my shipping cost table. Origin is my first column. Control destination is my second column. So 1, 1, 2, 2. So we simply just match this two. We're gonna do left outer join, this option. Everything else is gonna remain the same. I'm gonna press okay. And all I gotta do now is simply just expand this. So I'm gonna open this and whatever other columns I want from that second table, I would highlight here. Assuming I just want shipping cost, that would only be this. So I'm gonna press that, press okay, And believe it or not, we're done. So I'm gonna go close and load and do close and load two. And then here, this time I'm not gonna create a connection. I'm gonna load it to a table, to a new worksheet right here. Press okay, and it's gonna create that new worksheet for us. See, with the name merge one, and we got all of this here. Now, this is pretty much done, except that sometimes you may not like the fact that when it does this merge, the sorting order is not gonna match your original data order we have here. So see, we got like New York, then Philadelphia next. Here, it's probably not gonna be the same order. So if you want it to be the same order, I'm gonna show you how to do that too. So let me actually delete this, right click delete, and then I'm gonna delete this connection as well, right click delete, that merge, and I'm gonna repeat some steps I did. So again, I'm gonna find my first table, shipments, right click and do merge on this. And then shipments is my first table, shipping cost is my second table, click, control, click, 1, 2, click, control, click, 1, 2, done with that, press okay. Now here at this point, even though I have them merged, my table results here are still in the original order they used to be. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm just gonna go here on top and I'm gonna click add column and add an index column right here. And it's gonna go from 1, I guess, or 0, it doesn't really matter. I'll go with this. And we simply add this column that just goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, just like this. At this point, I should be able to expand this and again, choose whatever column I want, like so. And it looks like because of that index column, we already have our data sorted in the right order. But if it was not, at this point, you could still go here and do sort ascending by that index column to make sure it is. And then we can just delete that index column, right click and remove, and that should be our results in the order we like. At this point, we would go under home, do close and load two, and I'm gonna simply load it to a table, new worksheet, press okay, and here we go. We have our results, we have all the matching shipping costs, and see New York, Philadelphia, Chicago, Houston. If I go to my shipment table, you'll see everything is in the same order as we had before. So as you can see, very fast and easy, done using Power Query. Now, let's assume we don't have Power Query available. So what if we use Mac version of Excel or we're in Google Sheets? How do we solve this problem? Now for that, I'm gonna reopen a fresh version of this file. And this is what I have. I have my shipments here, shipping cost here. So to solve this problem for Google Sheets, Mac or website version of Excel, we're going to use filter function. And for that, we would do filter and open parentheses. And this is gonna ask us for an array. So the array is going to be the results column. So I'm gonna go to my shipping cost table right here and select this D column right here. So this entire column D is my results. So I'm gonna go ahead and select that, comma. Then I need this include, which is basically a logical array of trues and falses. And the way I'm gonna get that, I'm gonna use n function. I'm gonna do n, open parentheses. And then as a value for this n, we'll simply select this column A for origin. And I wanna match that origin to the origin I had in my current row. So I'll make it equal right here, equals. I'll go back to shipment and click on my from destination, which in this case is New York. Now, when you do this in Excel, it adds this name of the tab in front of the cell reference. This wouldn't have happened in Google Sheets. So I'm gonna get rid of that because we don't want it here. It should just be the cell reference. So this is my first array. So I'm going to close parentheses on this one. I'm going to add a multiplication sign and I'm going to do another n function right here. So this will be the second criteria that I'm trying to match. So for our second criteria to match this, we're going to go to that same shipping cost table. We're going to select this destination column B, the second column, and we'll say that should be equal to, we'll go to this shipment and simply click on 2 right here. And yet again, I'm going to remove that part where it adds the name of the tab in front of it. Let's actually pay attention to this formula here in the formula bar so it's easier to read this. So there it is. I'm going to close parentheses for this. So right now I have this second and function and the first and function both multiplied together to logical test arrays. Now, if you add more conditions, you can simply repeat this as many times as you like. You can do another multiplication, another and function, and do the next logical test. For me, I just had those two. So I don't need to keep doing this. I simply need to close my filter function at this point from right here. And if I hit enter, I should be getting the match. See? And at this point, all I have to do is to just drag this formula down. So if I just double click in this corner, I'm going to get all of the results. As you can see, that match those criterias. So let's just check a couple of those. See, like New York, Vegas, we already checked that one. Let's check this Philadelphia, Phoenix. So if I go and check Philadelphia, Phoenix, as you can see, it's right here, 1,124.33. If I go back here, there we are. We found our match. It works just fine. Now, let's also test this in Google Sheets to verify that the same formula works. So I'm going to copy the same exact formula I did here in Excel. We'll go to our Sheets environment, which is the same spreadsheet, as you can see, and I'm simply going to just paste that same exact formula with no difference whatsoever. I'm going to hit enter and we got our match, as you can see. And if I double click on this, I'm going to get all of my results just like that. No problem. And that should get us our lookup with multiple criterias right here. And it works just fine. Now, one thing I'm going to mention is that in order for this to work, you need to make sure there is only one match for each one of these. So if I go to this New York, Vegas, there shouldn't be two possible matches here in this table in order for this to work. Now, the first example I did with Power Query would actually handle those cases too. So if you have multiple matches, it will just duplicate the lines for those and give you both. Here, it wouldn't do that. It would basically just give you errors for those lines. Now, if you do have multiple lines, you have a solution for that as well to simply just put those in multiple columns here. So what that means, you could just take this whole thing and wrap it in a function called transpose, like so. And obviously, if you don't type your function names right, this is what's going to happen. So I'm going to go back and fix this. So it should be transpose, like so. And you'll see I'm going to get the same results if I drag this formula down like this, except that let me show you what's going to happen if I have more than one New York, Vegas combination. So if I go here to find that New York, Vegas here, there we are. I'm going to add another line right here and add that new combination. And let's just do a different number here. Let's just up it by $1,000. So now I have two matches for this, which means if I go here, see, it will spit out that second match. And this one is New York, Vegas too, in the next column over. If you have three matches, it would be three columns. So again, same thing you could have done in Excel, the same transpose function. This should work in Excel, Google Sheets, and Excel Online. And that's how you do lookups with multiple criterias. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.